Hi viewers, we will now discuss monotonic sequences. Before that, we will recall the definition of increasing function and decreasing function. A function y equal to f of x is called increasing or non-decreasing on the interval, open interval a comma b, if for all x1 comma x2 belong to the open interval a comma b such that x1 is less than x2 or x2 is greater than x1 implies f of x2 is greater than or equals to f of x1. That is, as the value of x increase, as the values of x increase, the value of the functional value of x also increase. Sometimes the functional values are equal. For example, let us consider the graph y equals to x cubed. This is a graph y equal to x cubed. Let us consider y equal to f of x and the function is x cubed and these are the values of x. And this curve represents y, that is f of x. Now let us check how it is increasing. Yeah, it's increasing, increasing. Now the values may be equal. Again increasing, increasing. As the value of x increases, the value of f of x also increases. But in this case, here, the values are almost same. And hence, this is an example of increasing function. Now, a function f of x open interval a comma b, if for all x1 comma x2 belong to the open interval a comma b such that x2 is greater than x1 implies f of x2 is strictly greater than f of x1. Look at this here. Here the values are strictly increasing. The values of x strictly increasing. Here also the functional value also strictly increasing. Whereas in the above example, we may have the two values may be equal, but here none of the two values of the function equal. And hence, this is a definition of strictly increasing function. For example, consider the curve y equal to e power x. See here, these are the values of x, these are the values of f of x. Look at the tracing here. As the value of x increases, f of x value also increases. As the value of x increases, f of x value also increases. And no two values of f of x are equal. Therefore, this is an example of strictly increasing function. A function y equal to f of x is called decreasing. Non-increasing on the interval a comma b, if for all x1 comma x2 belong to the open interval a comma b such that x2 is greater than x1 implies f of x2 is less than or equal to f of x1. Look at the inequalities here. In increasing function, both inequalities, the values of x and its functional values are the same symbol. Less than or equal to, less than, less than or equal to. Whereas here, less than, but here it is greater than or equals to. That is, the inequality is reversed. In the case of decreasing, we will have a different inequalities. If it is less, we have a greater. If it is greater, we have a less. And hence, a function y equal to f of x is called decreasing. If x2 is greater than x1 implies f of x1 greater 8 is not equal to f of x2. Look at the graph here. Here, the values of f are equal. Then, slowly the values of f of x decreases. Slowly the value of f of x decreases. Now, a function is said to be strictly decreasing on the interval a comma b if for all x1 comma x2 belong to a comma b such that x2 is greater than x1 implies f of x1 is strictly greater than f of x2. Now this example, here the values of x are increasing, values of x are increasing, but the value of f of x are decreasing. So this is an example of strictly decreasing function. Now we'll define what is monotonically increasing sequence. A sequence an is said to be monotonically increasing or non-decreasing if an plus 1 is greater than or equals to an for all n belong to n. That is, second term is greater than first term. Take n equal to 9, then it becomes a10. So a10 is greater than a9. Similarly here, as the value of n increases, the values of the sequence also increases. It's true for each and every value of n. Such a function, such a sequence is called monotonically increasing sequence. A sequence an is said to be strictly increasing if an plus 1 is strictly greater than an for all n belong to n. Here we have an equality symbol. Here there is no equality symbol. We'll discuss some example. First example is the sequence whose nth term is n, which have elements 1, 2, 3, 4, so on. This sequence is strictly increasing. Why? A1 is 1, the first term is 1, second term is 2, third term is 3, fourth term is 4. And hence, A2 is greater than A1, A3 is greater than A2, A4 is greater than A3, so on. That is, A1 is less than A2, less than A3, so on. In general, An plus 1 is strictly greater than An. Therefore, this is an example of strictly increasing function. Now, we will explain this using a graph. This is a graphical representation. Here, the graph is y equal to x. Now, what you have to do is, let us take An equals to y. An equal to y and x equals to n, then the sequence becomes the sequence an equals to n. So remember that this y is an, x is n, and hence here as the value of n increases, n equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, here a1, a2, a3, a4, a5, so on, and hence as the value of n increases, an plus 1 is greater than an. So here this is a5, maybe a6, a7, a8, so on. It is increasing. And hence this is an example of strictly increasing function. Now the sequence an, where an equal to n squared for all n belong to n, is strictly increasing because an equal to n squared and an plus 1 is n plus 1 whole squared, and hence we know that n plus 1 whole squared is greater than n squared. Therefore, an plus 1 is greater than an. Is true for all n belong to n. If you consider the sequence 1, 2, 2, 4, 4, 6, 6, so on. Here, A2, what is A2? 2. What is A1? 2. So, A1 equal to A2. The two terms are equal. A3 is 4. A2 is 2. So A3 is greater than A2. A4 is equal to A3. A5 is greater than A4. A6 is equal to A5. And hence, this sequence satisfies the condition, namely, An plus 1 is greater than or equal to An for all n belong to n. And hence, this is monotonically increasing sequence. Whereas example 1 and 2 are strictly increasing. This is monotonically increasing sequence. Now, a sequence An is said to be monotonically decreasing, or we say it is non-decreasing if An is greater than or equals to An plus 1 for all n belong to n. That is, suppose take n equal to 1, A1 is greater than A2, n equal to 5, A5 is greater than A6. That is, the value of the sequence decreases. N increases, n equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 increases, but the value of the sequence, namely A1, A2, A3, A4, so on, decreases. And hence, this is said to be monotonically decreasing sequence. A sequence An is said to be strictly decreasing if An is strictly greater than An plus 1 for all n belong to N. Here we have strictly less than symbol. Therefore, it is strictly decreasing. Examples. Let us consider the sequence whose nth term is minus n. Whose values are minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, so on, which is strictly decreasing. The reason is, we know that minus 1 is greater than minus 2, minus 2 is greater than minus 3, so on. What is minus 1? A1. What is minus 2? A2. What is minus 3? A3. And hence, A1 is greater than A2, A2 is greater than A3, so on. That is, in general, An is greater than An plus 1. Now, consider another sequence, An, whose nth term is 1 by n. For all n belong to n. What are the terms here? So, the terms of the sequences are 1, 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 4, 1 by 5, so on. Remember that A1 is 1, A2 is 1 by 2. Clearly, A1 is greater than A2, A2 is greater than A3, so on. So, this is an example of strictly decreasing sequence. Let us see the graph of the sequence An equal to 1 by n. Yeah, this example in fact. This is a sequence y equals to 1 by x. Here take y equals to an and x is equal to n. And hence it becomes y equals to or an equals to the sequence 1 by n. Look at this. Here values of n. This is the value of n. What is this curve? This curve is nothing but values of a1, a2, a3, so on. Now let us see the tracing. Yes, the values are decreasing. That is, An is greater than An plus 1, and hence this curve or this sequence is monotonically decreasing sequence. Now, the sequence 1, 1, 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 3, 1 by 5, 1 by 5, so on. Here, A2 is 1, A1 is 1. So, A2 is equals to A1. But here, 1 is greater than 1 by 3. Therefore, A2 is greater than A3. A3 equal to A4. But A4 is greater than A5, so on. And hence, this is monotonically decreasing sequence. A sequence An is said to be a monotonic sequence if it is either increasing or decreasing. That is, every increasing sequence is monotonic, every decreasing sequence is also a monotonic sequence. For example, if you consider the sequence 1, 1, 1, 1, so on, is both increasing and decreasing. Because here A1 is 1, A2 is 1, A3 is 1, A4 is 1, A5 is 1. That is, all the terms are equal. When you say a sequence is increasing sequence, we say that if An plus 1 is greater than or equal to An. That is, equality is there. When do you say a sequence is decreasing? We say sequence is decreasing if An is greater than or equals to An plus 1. In both cases, we have equality. Either less or equal, or either greater or equal. But here, all the terms are equal. And hence, it is both increasing sequence as well as decreasing sequence. What type of sequence is this? All the terms are the same. Such a sequence is called constant sequence. And hence, this constant sequence is a monotonic sequence. So, we can say that every constant sequence is both increasing and decreasing. And hence, it is a monotonic sequence. Let us consider another example. It's a well-known example. Minus 1 to the power n minus 1. The terms are 1 minus 1, 1 minus 1, so on. Here, what is A1? A1 is 1. A2 is minus 1. A3 is 1. A4 is minus 1. If you look at this, A1 is greater than A2. But A2 is less than A3. A3 is greater than A4. That is, A1 is greater than A2. A2 is less than A3. But A3 is greater than A4. Look at the inequalities. Do they follow uniformity? No. If it is increasing, always greater than or equal. If it is decreasing, always less than or equal. But here we have a less than, greater than. Therefore, it is neither monotonically increasing nor monotonically decreasing. Therefore, it is not a monotonic sequence. What type of sequence is this? We know that it is an oscillating sequence. It oscillates between minus 1 and plus 1. Therefore, now we can conclude that every oscillating sequence is neither increasing nor decreasing. And hence, every oscillating sequence is not a monotonic sequence. Let us consider one example here. This is an example of a sine curve. Y equal to sine x. If we take an as y, then it is sine n, not x, n. It is, y is taken as an, the sequence an, whose nth term is sine n. Now, what about this curve? Let us take the trace of this curve. Look at this, it is increasing. Increasing. Now, what happened? It is decreasing. Now, look at this, it is again increasing. Thus, the sine curve or the sine function or the sequence 0 to 90 is increasing, 90 to 270 is decreasing, 270 to 360 is increasing. And again, as a whole, if we take from 0 to 360 degrees, the interval 0 to 360, this sequence is neither increasing nor decreasing. Therefore, it is not a monotonically sequence, a monotonic sequence. If you take a part of it, a sub-interval, 0 to 90, see here, 0 to 90, it is increasing, increasing. But from 90 to 270, it is decreasing. Decreasing. Now look at this. from 270 to 360. Once again, it is increasing. If we take a part of a sequence, that sequence is either increasing or decreasing. But as a whole, it is neither increasing nor decreasing. Now consider sequence AN, whose nth term is N, where the elements are 1, 2, 3, 4, so on, is a monotonic sequence. We know that this is a monotonically increasing sequence. The sequence AN, whose nth term is 1 by N, where the elements are 1, 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 4, 1 by 5, so on. Here every term is less than its previous term. Therefore, it is monotonically decreasing sequence. Third one is monotonically increasing, fourth one is monotonically decreasing, and hence third and fourth examples are monotonic sequences. Whereas the first one is a constant sequence which is both increasing and decreasing, therefore it is a monotonic sequence. The second one is a oscillating sequence, which neither increases nor decreases. Therefore, it is not a monotonic sequence. Now, we have some results. The first result is every monotonically increasing sequence which is bounded above converges to its supremum. See here, every monotonically increasing, first condition. What second condition? Bounded above, then the sequence converges. Not only that, it converges to the limit. What's the limit? The supremum of the sequence. Same result we have here. Every monotonically decreasing sequence which is bounded below converges to its infimum. The first result is very, very important, because while doing problems, when you want to show that a given sequence converges, what we do? We use the first result. That is, first we show that the given sequence is monotonically increasing. The second thing is, we will show that it is bounded above. Then we can conclude it converges and converges to its supremum. The third result is a bounded monotonic sequence converges. We know that just now we discussed the example AN, whose nth term is 1 by N. That is 1, 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 4, 1 by 5, so on, is bounded. Because what is the greatest number here? 1 is the upper bound. What is the lower bound? When you take n tends to infinity, 1 by infinity tends to 0. But 0 does not belong to the sequence. Therefore, every element in this sequence lie between 0 and 1, including 1, equal sign, including 1. Therefore, this sequence has bounded above as well as bounded below, and hence it is bounded sequence. And this bounded sequence being decreasing sequence, which converges to its infimum. The next one is unbounded monotonic sequence diverges. Unbounded monotonic sequence diverges. Look at this example. The sequence AN, whose nth term is 1, N, the values of the sequence are 1, 2, 3, 4, so on. Is it bounded? No. Why it's not bounded? Because the lower limit is 1. What's the upper limit? Or what's the upper bound? The lower bound is 1. What's the upper bound? Does not exist. And hence, it is not bounded. It is unbounded. By this result, a bounded this sequence is monotonically increasing sequence. Therefore, it's a monotonic sequence diverges and this diverges to plus infinity. The fifth result is a monotonically increasing sequence which is not bounded above diverges to infinity. Look at this 1 and 5. 1 and 5. What's the comparison? What are the differences? 1 and 5. 1 says monotonically increasing, bounded above. But 5 says monotonically increasing, not bounded above. Here the sequence converges, whereas in the case of 5, the sequence diverges and diverges to infinity because it is increasing sequence. It is increasing sequence, therefore diverges to infinity. The example is the sequence whose nth term is n, whose elements are 1, 2, 3, 4, so on, is unbounded. Unbounded. Not bounded above. When you say unbounded, one of the condition fails. Either bounded above or bounded below. But here, it is not bounded above because what is the greatest number here? Does not exist. Therefore, it is not bounded above, but it is increasing sequence. Why increasing sequence? Look at the terms here. A1 is 1, A2 is 2, A3 is 3, A4 is 4. That is every term is increasing. Increasing. Therefore, this is monotonically increasing sequence, not bounded above. And hence, it diverges to infinity. The same similar result. A monotonically decreasing sequence which is not bounded below diverges to minus infinity. Can you guess the example for this? Yes, the example is sequence whose nth term is minus n. That is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, so on. This is a decreasing sequence because every successive term is less than its previous term. Here, every successive term is more than its previous term, therefore increasing. But here, every successive term is less than its previous term, therefore it is monotonically decreasing. This is not bounded below. What is the least number here? What's the least number? Does not exist. Therefore, it is bounded, not bounded below. And hence, this sequence diverges to minus infinity. Thus, we can conclude from the above results that a sequence, that is a monotonic sequence, either converges or diverges, but it cannot